going out of Ryan in San Diego, California, slightly closer than Japan, on our Catholic Answers Live app. It's Ryan. Hello, Ryan. Ryanovich, are you there, Ryan?
Yeah, I'm here.
Hey, great. What's your question for Trent?
Mike, a few of my atheist friends have made the objection, how can we be happy in heaven knowing that there are people in hell, maybe even our friends or family?
Sure.
Yes.
I think when we have to look at that question, we have to take a step back and ask, well, what is it? What makes us? Why would we be unhappy? Well, we don't like to see suffering. I mean, it's always hard when we see someone suffer. We ask, well, how can I be happy in that regard? But it's interesting that I know people. If you can think for yourself, you can think of people in prison, for example, who are suffering. You know, being in prison, mm-hmm. obviously, there's suffering that entails that, but even if I were to know a loved one who is in prison, if I knew they were there for a just reason, that wouldn't inhibit my ability to be happy right now. Now, I would be very disconcerted and upset if I knew that a loved one who was innocent was suffering in prison. I'd probably, if you think about it, you'd probably be thinking about that night and day and you can't get over it, that what's happening to them mm-hmm. is not deserved. It's wrong. So I think that when it comes to hell and when we are in heaven, our minds will be expanded and we'll be able to see things the way God does, and it will change what makes us happy. Because in this life, what makes us happy are very transitory, temporal things that can't ultimately satisfy us, because we were made for God. We desire infinite and perfect happiness. Only God can provide that. So in heaven, we will have that. It will be overabundant and flowing, and we'll see God as the greatest good, and being a part of the body of Christ as being that greatest good. So I think we'll be able to see, well, also Scripture in Revelation says that the sins of everyone will be laid bare at the end of time. And in heaven, we'll have a greater appreciation for sin. We'll mm-hmm. understand how awful and terrible it is, where in this life, the idea of sin is something that's made fun of.
Yeah, not to mention hell.
Exactly. So just the idea that, oh, sinners, why would we punish sinners? Because in this life, you talk about sin, you look like a religious hillbilly. Whereas when we're in heaven, in the perfect knowledge and goodness of God, will see the ugliness of sin and realize, how could we have ever joked about something like this? So to answer your question, Ryan, I think the point is that we will truly understand God and the happiness that comes from Him. We will understand those in hell are there for a just reason. They have freely chosen that. And just if God is able in His perfect goodness mm-hmm. to be able to be perfect goodness and being and happiness and light, understanding that that's going on, we'll share in that, and we will understand the justice involved in that and the grace and mercy that God has given us that instead.
We also can't imagine seeing things as God sees them. That's a bizarre thought, which is impossible without divine grace.
No, I mean, St. Paul says that now we look in a mirror dimly, then we shall see as face to face. And what he means is not a glass mirror, but in ancient, there were some glass mirrors at this time, but primarily in ancient Corinth, a mirror was a polished piece of bronze. Mm. So if you imagine looking into a polished piece of bronze, you would faintly make out your reflection in it. And what he's saying is, actually, that's what it's like now. In the future, it'll be even better than mirrors we have in the modern world today of what we will see.
Be like you're wearing bronze tan.
Yes.
Infinitely.
So I think that this is an objection. It's difficult to understand, like, how could this be? But if our happiness is tied up in other people, then the objection seems insurmountable. But if our happiness is in God and understanding His justice, then it makes sense. In fact, there's a great passage real fast here in C.S. Lewis's The Great Divorce. Mm-hmm. I remember a character in there where they go on the bus trip from heaven to hell and get to see what it's like, that there's a woman there who just won't be happy unless her son is in hell with her. I'm trying to remember the story, right? I might be missing it, but it's something along those lines. And you start
to see... She sounds really nice.
Right, but you see how sad this is that she can't go to heaven because she... It's either that or she has someone in hell and she needs to be there with them, but she's turning away from God and choosing the sinful path others choose and having a disordered view of where one's happiness truly comes from.
All right, Ryan, thanks for the call.